Good morning, Bay Street. Stephen Whiteside here with today's video newsletter for Friday, September 7th, 2012. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are above fair value. Not as enthusiastic as yesterday, but the market is on pause, waiting for U.S. employment numbers to come out at 8:30 this morning. Now, Thursday morning, we started the day with the futures being up in the pre-market, and then we had sort of a melt-up yesterday morning after the market opened, and we're now back on a buy signal for the TSX. Notice that we didn't take out the high from a couple of weeks ago, so we're looking for a move up above 12,187.50 to take us into new territory. And then our next target, of course, would be the high from back in late April up at the 12,343.80 area. Now, looking at the S&P 500, stronger day there. Big pop took out the previous high. So we're looking to take out resistance at 1437.50. That would certainly take us into new territory here. We're making multi-year highs right now in the NASDAQ, and NASDAQ certainly took out the previous high. And then we're looking for a move up. Our next target is 2851.56. So everybody seems to be happy right now, but those numbers coming out at 8:30 this morning, that could take some air out of the balloon. Global Dow now back on a buy signal. We had strength in Asia overnight. We have strength in Europe this morning. The bonds came down sharply yesterday, not enough to give us a sell signal. We need continuation to the downside. We need to take out yesterday's low on Friday to give us a new sell signal. No change in the U.S. dollar, no change in the euro, and no change in the Canadian dollar. Last time I checked, it was up a little in the pre-market this morning. So certainly when the Canadian dollar is rising, that is the risk on trade, and that's what you need to move the stock market higher. Next up, let's take a look at commodity prices, and no changes on Thursday. No change for crude oil, no change for natural gas. We are down a little once again back into the channel, but no sell signal as of Thursday's close. Looking at copper, no change there. Gold continued to move higher. We're $6 away from our 1718 target, but we did get over 1700, so that psychological resistance has been breached. Looking at silver, we moved up to our next target, so looking for a move up to, if we can move up above that target, so 3437.50 is our next target to the upside for the price of silver. Next up, let's take a look at the major Canadian indexes that I follow. So the TSX, big up day yesterday, and now back on a buy signal as of Thursday's close. Now, that doesn't dramatically change most of the major Canadian stocks. Just the index itself, with strength from the energy sector. So the energy sector is now back on a buy signal, but no change for financial services, no change for gold. Gold stocks, they're still on a buy signal. No change for the venture exchange. No change for copper stocks. Came up to the upper channel line yesterday, but not enough to give us a buy signal. Now, fertilizer stocks moved higher yesterday, and that index is back on a buy signal as of Thursday's close. No change for silver stocks, and no change for uranium stocks as of Thursday's close. Last up, a quick look at some 60-minute charts. New early warning signal coming into the close on Thursday, but we're still projecting higher prices here. The first sign of weakness on Friday is going to be an hourly close below 12,062. Notice the open gap here that could potentially act as an area of support. Both the top and the bottom of the gap can act as potential support on the way back down. Looking at energy stocks, first sign of weakness on Friday is going to be an hourly close below 254.70. For financial services, we would look for an hourly close below 178.08 to give us a new intraday sell signal on Friday. 317.34 for the gold sector. And for the venture exchange, the first sign of weakness on Friday is going to be an hourly close below 1252.03. Okay, folks, that's all for Friday morning. It's 8 a.m. and the Dow futures up about 44 points and half an hour till employment numbers come out. My name's Stephen Whiteside. If you want to find out more about theuptrend.com, please visit our website. Have a great day, have a great weekend, and I'll talk to you again next on Monday morning.